שיר למעלות ישעינה אלערים מאין יבוא עזרי עזרי מאין.
שלום וברכה, דיס דבר תורה יצא לעילוי נשמת יעקב בן מזל טוב, the father of Madame Koppel. May Hashem give his neshama in peace. Ba'olam haba. This week we have been celebrated the Hilula of Rabbi Shimon Bar Yohai, alav shalom. And this week we have been reading the Parsha of Behar, the mitzvah of Shemitah that Hashem gave us. The mitzvah of Shemitah, it's not an easy mitzvah. Shemitah, that means you can do this mitzvah only in Israel, in Eretz HaKodesh. That Hashem gave us a mitzvah that it's not easy to do it. If you have a land, you work your land for 6 years, and after six years, you have to leave the land Shabbat. Like on Shabbat, we don't work. On Shabbat, we have to rest. So the land should rest 1 year. It's not easy. It's a hard mitzvah. You know, this mitzvah, it's so hard. So our rabbi said that if somebody respects that mitzvah, it's like he become like a malach. Why the rabbis compare somebody who respects the Shemitah like a malach? Like a malach. You know what it is? A malach is an angel. An angel, he has no yitzhara. An angel, before Hashem give him an order to do, the angel is already to do what before Hashem ask him. Baruchu Hashem al achav, the malachim, they bless all the time Hashem. Ose dvaru, they are ready to do whatever Hashem said before they hear what Hashem wants from them. Usually you hear, and then you do, but the malachim know. The malachim are willing to do before they hear. And that's what the Bnei Israel did. Na'asi v'nishma. The Bnei Israel said to Hashem, when Hashem proposed them the Torah, they said, we'll do before you tell us. That means they become like malachim, like angels. And the rabbis compare the mitzvah of Shemitah, a man who respects the mitzvah of Shemitah is like an angel. Because it's very hard to do it. Just imagine a poor man. Let's not talk about rich people. A poor man who lives in Israel and he has a land, a small land, and all his parnasa is from that land. Can you imagine? He lives, all his life is this land, and now the year of the Shemitah, he is not allowed to take the fruit from that land to sell it to live. It's not easy. You must have a big bitachon, an emunah on Hashem. So HaKadosh Baruch Hu, you want to... Why Hashem give us this mitzvah? You know why? Because Hashem, he want to show us, you love me. So respect that mitzvah. Hashem, he want to teach us that the word, it doesn't belong to us. The word is, it belongs to Hashem. Because all the life, we think this, and we say, this is mine, this is mine, this is mine, this is mine. So Hashem said, okay, during 6 years you said, this is mine, this is mine. Now, what it is mine? So we tell him, well, everything is yours. Ah, everything is mine. So give me the year of Shemitah. Give me that year. I want to see if this is mine. Don't work it. Don't do nothing. Leave it. What about all? How I'm going to live? Well, how are we going to live? So you must learn to have faith on me. It's me who give Parnassah. My friend, just imagine this corona. For 2 months, that people, they didn't work. You know, look how the business, how the economic in the world is losing. How many bankruptcy? Here in Israel, what they are talking about, hundreds of thousands of people that with no work. In America, I saw the paper about 30 million people are without work. Can you imagine? Last a few months ago, most of 99% of the people of America do work. And now 30 million, maybe more, I don't know. How many businesses are closing? How many bankruptcy? Only for 2 months. So imagine 1 year in Israel, no one work. At the time, the business was around food because people, they exchange with food. Now there is no food. Or there is no business. You cannot sell all your land. I can imagine. Just imagine. It's incredible. During 1 year, all Jews in Israel, all the land are doing Shemitah. No business. That means you see your fruit and you have orders to ship them away. You cannot. It's the Shemitah. You cannot do nothing. Let people come to take what they want. And you cannot do nothing for you. No business. V'shavta ha'aretz, the land should do Shabbat. If you do that, you are stronger. Gibore Korah. You are a strong man. You have emuna l'Hashem, so you are an angel. Because the angels before, they hear what Hashem wants from them, they do. And you have the Korah, like the an angel. An angel, he has the strength to do before he hears. Because he has no Yetzara. And you live in this world, and you have Yetzara, and Yetzara tell you, go and work your land, sell it, eat, do whatever you want to do. You don't do it. During 1 year, you don't do it. You have, and it will take 2 years, really. It's 2 years. Because you don't work it 1 year, and then when you start working it, she will give you a fruit, and she will give you what she needs to give you. So it will take 2 years or 3 years. I don't know how many years. You do that, you are strong. You are strong. And that's why this mitzvah was given and mentioned in the Torah that it was given in Har Sinai. Why this mitzvah, it was mentioned in the Torah that it was given in Har Sinai. All the mitzvot, they were given in Har Sinai. But why the Torah mentioned only this one? Because this one, show you and prove you that you are an angel if you respect it. Those angels that they were against you before Hashem created you, those angels that they were against you, that Hashem will not give you the Torah, by respecting this mitzvah, you show them that it was worth it that Hashem created them, and it was worth it that Hashem he give them the Torah. I mean, he created me and he gave me the Torah. Because those angels, they were against you. And now, you compare yourself to them. So you know what they do? They come to Hashem and they tell Hashem, Hashem, thank you that you didn't listen to us. When we told you, don't create Adam and don't give him the Torah. Now he acts more than us because he lives in a world where there is a Tzara and the he show himself strong against the Tzara, and he do exactly, he respect, he's willing to do before he listen. Can you imagine? When the year of Shemitah come, I am already ready to do it. Before I will be in the year of the Shemitah, already during 6 years, I prepare myself to do it. I'm willing to do it. And I don't want to hear about business. I don't want to hear nothing. I'm hearing only what Hashem wants from me. My friend, to do this mitzvah of Shemitah, you have to be very strong. And if you do it, so you are an angel, you are a malach. People today, how can they show that we don't want to be malach? We are human being. We are nothing. We came with nothing, and we go with nothing. When you respect the mitzvah of Shemitah, the 7 years, after 6 years, during the 7 years, you respect it. You see the land during 1 year, 2 years, 1 year. You see how the land is rotten, all the fruit are, you see all the fruit, you cannot sell them, they become rotten, you know. Anyone who wants to come, who want them, welcome, come. There is signs everywhere. You want fruit? You want tevuah? You want kemah? Whatever you want, come, take. There is signs everywhere. And the poor people, they enjoy themselves. Everybody enjoy, even the animals, they enjoy themselves. Can you imagine? You see this all the time. And you do nothing. You see your land getting rotten. You can do nothing. You see millions of dollars going away. You do nothing. Are you not strong? Yeah. Who give you this koah? From where did you get this koah? From where? It's up to your emuna. It's up to how much you've been working for yourself to believe in Hashem. The more emuna you have, you can be more stronger. If you can respect that mitzvah of Shemitah, you can respect everything. That way, this mitzvah was, the Torah said, mentioned that it was given Har Sinai. Because if you do that mitzvah, you are the best. You are a malach. You are an angel. Yes, my friend. This mitzvah of Shemitah showed you, when you respect it, how much you love Hashem, how much you have emunah on Hashem. This week we celebrate the Hilulah of Rabbi Shimon Bar Yohai. Rabbi Shimon Bar Yohai, the day that Moshe Rabbeinu was in the Shamaim, and HaKadosh Baruch Hu proposed him to give him the Torah Shebichtav, the Torah Shebe'apa, the Torah, the mitzvot, and the secret of the Torah. Both. There is the mitzvot and the secret of the mitzvot. It's like you buy something electronic, and there is a patent. And the patent is the secret. Like Coca-Cola. Coca-Cola, I mean, we know how it's made, but there is a secret that no one knows. There is something extra that nobody knows what they put. And everything that you see, there is a patent. There is a secret of that thing. So there is the Torah, there is a secret of the Torah. The Jewish people, they wanted the Torah, not the secret. They said to Hashem, we leave the secret for you. We do. We are willing to do. We are malachim. We will do before we hear. But Hashem said, no. You cannot take only the Torah. I want to give you the secret as well. Because with the secret of the Torah, Mashiach will come. Because the whole Torah should be here. I'm not leaving nothing up. When I, when Moshe Rabbeinu went to the Har Sinai, to the Shamayim, when he came back, he bring with him everything, and the Torah and the circuit of the Torah. Who represent the circuit of the Torah? Rabbi Shimon Bar Yohai. David HaMelech said about Moshe Rabbeinu, Alita Lamarom, you went up, Shavita Shivi, and you fighted the angels, and you took from them all the circuit of the Torah. Shivi is the initial of Shimon ben Yohai, Shivi. Lakahta matanot ba'adam. You took all the good neshamot that they were on Adam HaRishon. Among them, Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai, and all the neshamot that they represent the secret of the Torah. So now, in this world, we have everything. But the secret of the Torah that they were given to Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai, no one was allowed to divulge them till Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai came. When Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai came, so he was the only one to have permission to divulge all the secret of the Torah. Because through the secret of the Torah, Mashiach will come. So today, there is a lot of Mikubalim. There is today a lot of yeshivot that you read the Zohar, because this is, once we will understand the secret of the Torah, Mashiach will come. And today, Baruch Hashem, we live in this generation that we have everything. We never had much Torah in all generation like our generation. Jewish schools, yeshivot, kolilim, kosher food, mikvaot. Wow. We have everything. Books. Billions of books. Every year we write books. Torah. We live today in the generation of Mashiach. And never people, they have been learning Torah like during these 2 months of that people were staying home. They were listening to Shiorim, respect Shabbat, they pray. Because people have nothing to eat, nothing to do. Just sitting. So they're listening. Torah. And people are enjoying it. The most important is now. I mean, after the confinement, after these 2 months that we've been home, and now we started to go out. Well, this is the moment to show that you are a mensch, that you are an angel. When Hashem created the world, and then he wanted to create Adam, he saw the neshama of Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai. That the neshama, it's the secret of the Torah. So Hashem decided to create the man. Na'ase Adam ne'emar ba'avorecha. When Hashem said, let's create a man. When he said, let's create a man, he thought Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai. Why only Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai? Why there is no other tzaddikim? There is a lot of tzaddikim. Abraham, Yitzhak, Yaakov, Moshe, Aaron. No. Na'ase Adam ne'emar ba'avorecha. When Hashem decided to create the world, and to create the man that he is the one that he will maintain the world, because he showed Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai. Why? You know why, my friend? Because really Hashem, he didn't need that people will know the secret of the Torah. Enough if the people, they will respect Torah and mitzvot. They don't need the secret of the Torah. But Hashem, he saw that without the secret of the Torah, the word cannot function. The word will be, it's like somebody who has a problem with his foot, he cannot run. Or somebody that is paralyzed, he cannot walk. He's alive, but he cannot walk. He's paralyzed. Hashem is so that without the circuit of the Torah, the man will be paralyzed. He cannot walk. He cannot fight the Tzara at 100%. So we need, when Hashem is so the Neshama of Rabbi Shimon Bar Yohai, that represents the circuit of the Torah, the energy of the Torah, so Hashem creates Adam. Na'aseh Adam ne'ema ba'aborecha. That Neshama of Rabbi Shimon Bar Yohai was very, very special. That's why Moshe Rabbeinu, when he was in Har Sinai to receive the Torah, and the Jews, they said, Na'aseh v'nishma, because Hashem, he told them, I cannot give you the Torah, just the Torah. You have to accept the secret of the Torah. The Jews, they said, we don't need it. Hashem, no. Without the secret of the Torah, you will be paralyzed. The Yetzirah will beat you. The energy of the mitzvah is when you know the secret of the Torah, so you will know, even if you don't know the secret of the Torah, only because you know that you accepted the secret of the Torah, so, like, it will help you. The king, or a president, when you give orders, when you give a law, you don't see the king, you don't see the, just, you know, this is what the king wants. This is what, so you do it. But why? He said, do it, so do it. He knows what it is. A lot of times, we don't ask questions. There is one road, only one way. Why one way? Why only one way from this side? Why not one way from the other side? Why this is the law? We will not ask questions. You have to pay tax. Why I have to pay X tax? This is the law. So Hashem as well. Hashem, He gave us the Torah with the laws. There is laws that we understand, there is laws that we don't understand, there is circuit of the Torah. Hashem, He said, if He tell you do that, He knows why He tell you. He has His reason. It's for your own good. Moshe Rabbeinu, he proposed the Torah to the Bnei Israel. And they said, we accept it. We don't need the secret. Hashem said, if you don't have the secret of the Torah, you will be paralyzed. But we don't need. Just, it's for your own good. Even if you don't read them, even that you don't know what it is, the secret, just by accepting them, look, if I was a billionaire and I tell you, I'm going to write you a check, and you tell me, thank you very much, it's enough what you already give me. No, I'm going to give you a big check. I will tell you, thank you. Would I ask you, how much, what you gonna write? Nah, it's not fair. As you say. And then when we discover the amount that the king gave me, wow! Hashem give us the Torah and the circuit of the Torah. We don't know what it is, the circuit of the Torah. But when we start discovering the circuit of the Torah, wow! That was Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai. Alita l'marom shavit hashivi. And the secret of the Torah, it's na'aseh v'nishma. So Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai represents na'aseh v'nishma. The Torah shbichtav, the Torah that we know, and the secret of the Torah. Both of them. A lot of times in the Mishnah, we read the Mishnah, Rabbi Shimon Omer, Rabbi Shimon said. That means that Rabbi Shimon, he was the man of Torah Shebichtav and Torah Shebealpe, and this, the Torah that we understand and the circuit of the Torah. And this is Rabbotai, to be strong like an angel, it's when you respect mitzvot that you need to be strong to respect them. Now, for people who live outside Israel, they don't have Shemitah. Only people who live in Israel, they do Shemitah. They can respect the 7 years to, but not work it. But what about those who live outside Israel? So they have Shabbat. Shabbat. If they respect Shabbat all the time, Shabbat is like Shemitah. Shabbat is the 7 days. 6 days you work, and the 7 day you respect it. Do that. If you do that, so I'm sure if you were in Israel, you had the land, you will respect it. So you are a malach. My friend, now we understand why Hashem gave us the Torah. The 6 day of Sivan. And the Torah was given on Shabbat. To tell you that to be a servant of Hashem only if you respect Shabbat. You respect Shemitah. God bless you. And this is the Torah, Le'il Nishmat. Yaacov and Mazal, for the family couple, Miami, may Hashem take his neshama and Gan Eden, Amen Kiratzo.
Adonai ishmor cha mikol ra, ishmor et nafshecha, Adonai ishmor tzedcha uvoecha. Me'atah